in the eyes of many, attempting to research magic is something of a paradox. I certainly can't blame them for believing such a thing. Most magic users barely even know the actual processes behind magic in the first place. And yet, researching magic is my life's work. Many people have asked about the research itself, and so I believe it is time that I divulge my findings. Before delving into the particulars, it is perhaps best to begin describing magic at a surface level. I started research into the field of magic nearly 2 years ago, beginning with the simple descriptions of how it came to prosper from others and my own experiences. It was at this stage that I noticed a few peculiar details. In broad terms, magic requires three ingredients in order to form: the intent to create or destroy, the ability to command the magic as it forms, and ether. We'll cover ether at a later point. It is something somewhat more complex and less intuitive to understand, but the intent and ability are rather easily understood. Without the intention to create or destroy something, magic cannot be brought into existence. This is why emotional instability can bring about more dangerous forms of magic, especially when it comes to such emotions as anger or hatred. On the other hand, in order to bring magic into the world, the magic user must also have the ability to command it all. Training and talent are the primary components of ability, and without one or the other, it is difficult for even the greatest of intents to produce much more than a spark of magic. In the creation of magic, these two necessary factors are relatively understood by a majority of the general public. However, over the course of my studies in the otherworldly countryside of Ikor and the glorious city of Aria, I have come upon another necessary factor for the creation of magic: ether. If I were to put it into understandable terms, ether is a sort of invisible substance, I suppose, that composes much of the world around us. As we need air for our lungs, so too do we need ether for our magic. Even if ether is everywhere, it is also a highly personalized artifact, held deep within the hearts of each and every one of us. To use that ether and create magic for all the world to see is an embarrassing, albeit extraordinary, feat. The magic and its processes are yours and yours alone. For anyone else to see it is for them to see the most hidden facets of your identity. Your imagination and your abilities are laid bare for all the world to see. Such a reveal can be the destruction of oneself, and so I must applaud everyone who has decided to use magic even once, much less those who use it twice. For those who hear my speech today and henceforth, I ask you to keep one thing in mind. I'm not talking about magic at all.